Welcome inside the Didsbury Memorial Complex. Game 7, North Division Final. Winner moves on to the Heritage Junior Hockey League Championship Series against Okotoks. Thomas De La Ciega in between the pipes for the Mountain View Colts. And it is Cole Sears making the start for the Red Deer Vipers. He started the last two, won them both, so they go right back to him. He also won a Game 7 earlier this postseason against Three Hills on the road. Can he go 2-for-2? We'll see if we are underway here in Didsbury. As the Mountain View Colts start out with it, here's Ingram in the neutral zone. Now it comes up the other way, and Red Deer will be on the attack, at least for now, tied up just inside the blue line. Now over to Cole Sutherland, and he's out for Mountain View. Sutherland right in, one-timer, good chance, and a good stop by Sears. Colton Anderson gets the first real good look at the hockey game for Mountain View. Mountain View led this series 3-1. But the Red Deer Vipers won Game 5 on the road and went home and laid the boots pretty good to Mountain View, 8-2 in Game 6. So another one-timer on the near side. Blocked, here comes Logan Linnell back the other way. Linnell tries to get around Jacob Vanderzag, knocks him off of the puck, and Linnell looking to center. He does to Lawson. His shot got blocked. Vanderzag in his own zone. He's tied up by Linnell, trying to dig this loose. Lawson. Now LaPointe right in front. Linnell near side. Lawson scores! Bailey Lawson! Red Deer's got the early strike in Game 7. It's 1-0. Turnover in the zone costs Mountain View. And a little bit of that that turnover causes some chaos. Lawson gets lost on the near side and just has to tap one in right at the post. No chance for Thomas De La Ciega. And the Red Deer Vipers have a 1-0 lead in Game 7. 2 minutes and 13 seconds in. We'll go Lawson from Linnell and LaPointe, L cubed, to get us going here in the deciding game of the North Division Final. But the Colts come right back the other way. A centering pass intercepted neatly by Brody Kalinowski. Now put up to Brett Hoppus. Hoppus into the middle, back difference, skates right in. He shoots, it's blocked. He's got a goal to Zane Leatherdale. Leatherdale will skate out the far side. Leatherdale puts this in deep for Mountain View. Gathered by Dalton Angletwit. And Angletwit will start out for Red Deer. Angletwit starts out over the center line. Now he carries it on the right, tries to move it over to the left, but intercepted deftly by Josh Getty. There's Zane Leatherdale. Leatherdale into the middle. Visser kick back to Houshen. Shot it wide. I think it went wide after hitting a body in front. Damian Shelpeck moves to Hoppus, and Hoppus will skate out for Red Deer on the right wing. Hoppus, he gets knocked off of the puck, and Corbin Houshen's got it for Mountain View. Houshen to Ryan Clink. Clink comes right in on Kingwell. Centering pass, a one-timer, great save by Sears. Just got a glove on it and deflects up and out of play on the two-on-one. The Mountain View Colts nearly tie the game. 14:51 to go, first period. Johnston on the draw, one cleanly though by Clink. Rothenbusch back to his brother Lane, who shot it from the high slot, and a good save by Cole Sears. Damian Chopek starts out through center. Chopek looking to move this now that he's in the offensive zone. Can it'll come out. Declan Johnston and the Red Deer Vipers got to regroup. Chopek now on it. Chopek moves to Johnston right up the gut. Now it comes to Sim. Back to Johnston. Johnston to Sim. Scores! Lane Sims got a pair in back-to-back games. Two straight games with a goal for Lane Sim, and it's 2-0 Red Deer. Another puck coughed up by the Colts in their own zone. And the Red Deer Vipers, with 13:43 to go here in the first period, have a 2-0 lead. Kingwell will try to chip this one in. It was Kingwell, excuse me. It's Austin Thorne, the Moroccan Magnum PI look for the playoffs. Puts it in deep, hits the curved glass, and that'll be a whistle for that. It's 13:35 to go here, first period. Here's Austin Peterson on the draw, and it'll be one back to Dowd. Now Reagan Kime knocked off it. Sullivan will get it to Drew Joslin. Joslin steps around one. Still on the puck. Joslin offensive zone. Up top. Thorne shoots and it goes wide. I think, I'm not sure if there's blocked or if Della Ciega got a piece of that with the pad. But here come the Mountain View Colts. This is Jelitis, back up top. Now it's Dowd. Tees one up. Gets blockered up and just over the net. Now a centering pass. Back to the line. It'll come, though. Rothenbusch, Jelitis in the corner. Down. Now Rothenbusch. Reagan Kime. Peterson shoots. Good stop by Sears. No rebound. Getting right into the door, right to the doorstep there was Reagan Kime, but no rebound to speak of. Stays 2-0 Red Deer. 11:45 to go here in the first period. Draw one by the Vipers. Sullivan will move it to Austin Thorne, and now here's Logan Linnell on the left wing. Linnell gets around one. Looking to get this to the net. He cannot do so yet. Centers to Lawson. Lawson now right out front to slot. It's poked off his stick. And the kill. Brown will move that one up the far side. Tolton Anderson's got it now to the captain, Sutherland. Sutherland tries to get around Thorne. Thorne has him played deftly. Well, that one nearly coughed up by Sutherland. Now it is Ingram to that's Sutherland in the slot. There is Anderson. Ingram now in the corner. Ingram shot from the slot gets blocked, and here comes Logan Linnell. Linnell now to Lawson. Lawson able to get it to Lapointe to Lawson. Now it's Logan Linnell. Linnell in the offensive zone to Lawson. Oh, he just had that one fanned on. Is just breaking it up was Jacob Vanderzag. Would have had a real clean look. See there, top plus minus. A lot of Vipers in there, and that's frankly because they've had to play the most games. Each of their first two series since we've moved to best of sevens in round 2, 3, and 4, each of their first two series now have gone 7 games. And Mountain View was involved in a long series last time out too. Defeated the Statler Lightning in 6. Here now a chance to come right in, and Sears will have that one roll harmlessly to him. He will cover it up. So your top 10 in hits there, Jacob Vanderzag and Spencer Dowd, each in the top 10. Sim Johnston, Yates, the forward line out there for Red Deer, Rothenbusch, Clink, and Clink for Mountain View. Lane Sim skates onto this. In his own zone, looking to move this one out. He'll skate it out himself. Gain the center line and put it in deep. Gathered there by Jack Vergowan. Vergowan up the near side to Clink. Clink pestered by Sim. Sim able to come out with it briefly, but Houshin takes it right back. Now it's going to come right to Kingwell. Move to Damian Chopek. Chopek over to Spencer Yates. Yates trying to drive it wide. Centering pass for Johnston. Loose puck right in front. Vergowan takes the rebound away. Clink over to the near side. 7:11 to go here in the period. Here is Clink. Taken away there by Keegan Kingwell. Now to Declan Johnston. Johnston skating around the back of the net. Can't find an option. Chopek now to Tristan Zarubiak. Zarubiak starts out. Gets to Lane Sim. Sim will try to drive this one wide. Sim looking in front. He centers it. Zarubiak was there. Couldn't get a stick on it. Rolls all the way to the far corner, and the Mountain View Colts will come out with it. Getty into the middle to Mitch Visser. Visser trying to get around a defender, couldn't do so. The captain, Engeltwit, moves it up to Jackson Goodall, and Goodall puts it in deep. 5.25 to play here, first period. Now stuck at the side of the goal, no one on it. Zarubiak able to skate all the way back and find it. Center and out front scores! Jackson Goodall! It's 3-0 for the Red Deer Vipers! Don't go away yet. Red Deer took a 3-0 lead in Game 6 as well with less time left. Mountain View looked like they were going to make a game of it. Got it to 3-2. Of course, Red Deer ended up exploding in the third for 5. But far from over, but exactly the start you look for on the road. 3 first period goals for Red Deer. The last time these two teams were involved in a Game 7 in this building was in 2017. It was also a North Division final, a game Red Deer won on the road again. A shot now from the line gets deflected. Nearly handcuffs Della Ciega, but he's able to keep it out. However, the previous game seven period between these two teams was in the North semifinal in Red Deer, a weird situation where the Vipers were not able to occupy their actual home rink, the Service Arena. They were at Kansas City A for that one. Reason being, the Canada Winter Games in Red Deer took them out of their home building. Now there's Wilson snapping one just wide from point blank range. That game was won by the Mountain View Colts in double overtime. And that was a series, of course. Red Deer led 3-0. And a game seven, Red Deer led 3-0, funnily enough, what the score is right now. Big blocker save there by Cole Sears. And now Aiden Wilson's got control, moves to Dalton Angletwit. Angletwit looking to skate it out and does. Comes in over the near sideline. Centering pass now, far side. Oh, what a stop by Delaciega! That was Brett Hoppus from Matt Difference on a one-timer, and Thomas Delaciega absolutely robs him. Red Deer leads in the faceoff department. Now that's an even 6-6 as the Colts control here in their own zone. This is Colton Anderson moving it up to Evan Ingram. Ingram in the neutral zone, knocked off of the puck by Sullivan. And Sullivan will get it in, but the Colts will come right back out. Here's Jacob Vanderzek trying to get around Thorne. He does a centering pass. Good job to take away there by Linnell. But now here's Sutherland into the corner. Around the boards, it'll work there for Ingram. Tied up by Thorne. Sutherland in behind the goal. Now Anderson. Ingram, backhander save. Rebound cleared by the Vipers, and it will come out, forcing the Mountain View Colts to regroup. Here's Cole Sutherland, though. Sutherland hits Ingram the trailer. He couldn't get a shot away. Thornton couldn't clear. Now he gets it up to Drew Joslin. Joslin will get it out. 35 seconds to go here in the first period. Joslin looking to the near side, intercepted there by Colton Anderson. Anderson moves to Vanderzek. Vanderzek tries to hit the stretch pass there, but it works all the way in deep. Sullivan's got it. Final 5 seconds on the clock here. Sullivan will just try to take him off and nearly turned it over, and the shot came just as the buzzer expired. But no harm, no foul. 3-0 Vipers lead it through 20 minutes here in Game 7. Still not over yet. 40 minutes of hockey to go, and this Mountain View Colt team, a lot of offense. But don't go anywhere yet, as there is the early strike for Red Deer. Lawson gets one, so does Lane Sim. And this was the third strike. The fourth line gets on the board too. Jackson Goodall from Tristan Zarudiak. 3-0 Red Deer through 20 minutes. 8-6, the Colts outshoot Red Deer, but 3-0 where it counts. Back inside the Didsbury Rec Memorial Complex for period number two of game seven. Little work to do for the Colts. Now over to the far side, Linnell jamming away. Trying to go short side on a sharp angle. And now it's Linnell again from distance this time. His shot got blocked. Red Deer hungry start here to the second period. And Cale Brown will skate this out. Brown now trying to get around Angletwit. Could not do so. Angletwit's got it now. Angletwit turned it over to Anderson, but Linnell right on it to help out. Linnell skates this out the left side. Turned over, however, and Dalton Angletwit gets it in the neutral zone. Angletwit carries in far side, puts it in deep for the Vipers. There's Jacob Vanderzek trying to dig this one loose. That was Lawson. Over to the far side, Cole Sutherland, now Evan Ingram. Ingram will skate it in. Ingram on the right. Trying to get around Keegan. That's Brody Kalinowski. A good hit, though. Didn't allow that to happen. Red Deer has really made it hard to get to the scoring areas for the Mountain View Colts tonight. Here's Aiden Wilson. Wilson hits Kalinowski. Kalinowski shoots it from distance. No rebound. Covered up by Thomas Delaciega after a glove save. See your top 10 in assists there. A lot of Vipers on the board again. See Josh Getty and Mitch Visser as well in there for the Mountain View Colts. Getty, Visser out there right now. So are Hoppus, Wilson, and Difference for Red Deer. Leatherdale rounds out the trio for the Mountain View Colts. Corbin Hauschen moves up to Zane Leatherdale, and Leatherdale will come in on Keegan Kingwell. Leatherdale steps around him well. A shot, good save by Sears in tight. Now this one will come back to the line. Centering pass, Getty. Getty shoots, good glove save, Sears. Leatherdale tied up in the corner by Damian Chopek. Here's Brett Hoppus trying to start out for the Vipers and does. Hoffus carries in on the left wing. Tries to drive it wide. He's tripped up, and the first penalty of the game will go to Mountain View. Centered pass. Scores! Red Deer doesn't need a power play, they say. Mac Difference makes it 4-0 with the Vipers net empty on a delayed penalty call. And the Vipers, who, of course, looked like the more desperate team a couple of nights ago in Game 6 facing elimination, have just not been close to the Mountain View Colts in terms of the level of intensity they've brought tonight. Even though the shots favor Mountain View to a degree, it's been Red Deer that's played really well defensively. It's a lot of perimeter shots for Mountain View. And they've got found a way to get to the scoring areas in this game. And they've been rewarded with a 4-0 advantage here in the seventh game of the series. Hard hit down low. Yates got a chance out front. Backhander. Save Delaciega. If he didn't hold on to that with a rebound, there's a tap in on the doorstep for Johnston. This is a 5-0 hockey game. Look at the hit down low. Hard forecheck by Spencer Yates. Fourth line's out there. It's good old Joslyn Jerubiak for Red Deer. Peterson, Jelinas, and Kime for the Colts. Draw won by the Vipers. Joslyn spins away from a check, and now Sullivan. Sullivan rims around the boards. It'll work over to his defense partner, Thorne. Thorne to Jerubiak. Jerubiak couldn't do anything with it and ends up turned over. And now here is the Colts. They're going to get this one in deep. Gathered by Austin Thorne. Oh, he got plastered in deep. And now a turnover maybe by Red Deer, but Joslyn able to recover in time and make sure nothing too bad comes of that. Jackson Goodall will get it out on the left. Goodall now carrying it in. Poked off of the puck. Goodall skates right back onto it. Goodall to Drew Joslyn. Joslyn tied up along the wall. Now it'll come to Jamie and Chopek, and Jackson Goodall will gain the line here right side. He's knocked off the puck hard. It'll work over to Josh Getty. Getty spinning away from a check. There's a good bump in down low by Joslyn, but the Colts maintain possession. Here is Lane Rothenbusch. Rothenbusch taking it over the line. Centering pass, Getty. Far side. Jelinas just missed. Jelinas inches from putting the Colts on the board. But it stays 4-0, and now maybe a 2-on-1. Red Deer Sim drops up to the line. Chopek driving a stop made with the blocker by Delaciega. Chopek again. Now Yates. Sim shoots. Save Delaciega. He covers it up. 10.25 to go here in this second period. Red Deer 4, Mountain View no score. Sim had a 2-on-1. He elected. Not a bad play to hit the trailer from the line. Wide open was Damian Chopek. His slap shot denied, though. There's a chance from the far side. Stop there. And here comes Zane Leatherdale. Trying to get around Dalton Engletwit, who hasn't played perfectly. And Engletwit now tied up with Leatherdale in deep. Engletwit on the battle there. Back to the line, Corbin Houshin. Houshin is knocked off of the puck, and now it'll come to Aiden Wilson. Wilson looking to start in, gets in over the line, and Hoppus there to help out, but Hoppus, who picked up the puck, was offside. 9:03 to go, second period. Faceoffs 9-8 in favor of the Red Deer Vipers. Cale Brown retreats back, goes over to the far side. Plank now up to Allen Plank. Plank gets a hard hit there from Dalton Engletwit. It'll work to Aiden Wilson. Wilson trying to get it right in. He could not do so. Now here is Peyton Rothenbusch. Knocked off of the puck. Centering pass. Allen Plank denied. Glove save. Cole Sears hasn't been tested like that. Borderline all night. But he flashes the leather and keeps it out. 7:52 to go here in the second period. Lawson on the draw, defensive zone against Devin Ingram for Mountain View. Ingram won it cleanly. Brown, far side, Anderson just got a piece of it, Sears, and he keeps it out. Dug loose by Lawson, but he turned it over Brown. Van Der Zang. One timer blocked. Now Ingram. Ingram comes right in. Ingram shoots it. Save. Rebound. Another stop by Sears. Got it with the left pad. Top line for Mountain View. All over Red Deer. And now here's Sullivan skating it through a dangerous area, but he's able to get this to Linnell and out. Now Linnell's tripped up and it's touched up by Mountain View. So despite all the chances for the Colts, Jacob Van Der Zang takes a tripping penalty on Logan Linnell here, and the Colts will have to kill one off for 2 minutes, and Red Deer gets a power play. First one of the game, and a chance to really put the screws to Mountain View with a 5-0 lead. Draw is one here by Red Deer. Lawson couldn't get a shot away to Johnson. Centered, scores! Mac Difference, early strike on the power play. It's 5-0 Red Deer. Red Deer bends and doesn't break in their own zone. They draw the penalty and score on the power play, and they've got the Colts on the run. 5-0, the Vipers lead. As the power play cashes in, so the Red Deer Vipers, with six and change to go, have a 5-0 lead, but the Colts now will get a chance on a power play of their own to get it right back. Spencer Yates going off for tripping. Trips up Getty right off the draw after the Vipers do make it 5-0. Red Deer yet to be tested on the PK, and their PK has gone hot and cold. Here's a draw one by Dowd. To Dowd, now over to the near side plate. Here is Visser. Visser right in. Poke checked away from him by Sears. Now Dowd, near side. Rothenbusch couldn't get the shot away. Sim tries to clear and can't. Hard hit at the line. Sim's got it. Sim looking to move this. Instead, he's going to gain the line himself and put it in deep. Take the first 30 seconds off this Colt power play. And late Rothenbusch will move this up the far side to Mitch Visser. Visser now to Alan Clink. Clink trying to get it in on Kalinowski. His shot blocked. Kalinowski is now tripped up right in front. So 53 seconds is all the Mountain View power play will last. And Mitch Visser will go into the penalty box here. So we'll play 4-on-4 for 1:07. And Red Deer will get 53 seconds on the man advantage on the back end. Johnston on the draw, lost it. Corbin Hauschen will skate it out. Hauschen knocked off that by Damian Chopek. And now Declan Johnston over to the far side. Connor Sullivan will skate right in. Sullivan taken off the puck though by Hauschen. Now over to the far side, Jack Vergallen. Vergallen's got to get around Chopek and does, but Sullivan in there to help out. Johnston gets it from Mac Difference. Difference is knocked back off. Sorry, that's Johnston knocked off of it. And here come the Mountain View Colts again back the other way. Cole Sutherland. He's got Getty in the net. Sutherland shoots it himself. Save the rebound. Sullivan's got it. Moves up to Cale LaPointe. 8 seconds to go in 4-on-4. Then Red Deer gets a shortened power play. Now out of the box. Steps Spencer Yates. Red Deer on the power play now for 45 seconds. Here's Declan Johnston. Carrying it right in. Good play there by Van Der Zang. Now knocked off the puck hard there. Vipers have it. They're onside. Here is Declan Johnston. Taken off it by Brown. And Brown will clear the length of the ice. Final 20 seconds on the Viper man advantage. Maybe they can have a chance off a rush if they hurry here. There is Dalton Angletwit. Moving to Spencer Yates. Yates carries in. Yates looking to center. We're back to 5-on-5. Yates held up. 3:20 to go here in the second period. Red Deer 5, Mountain View no score. And another penalty is coming right up again. This is to Mountain View. Van Der Zang for hooking this time. Gets a stick into the midsection of Aiden Wilson. So a 3:01 to go in the second. The Vipers have another power play opportunity. This one is... ooh, that was pretty close, but it looks like they're saying it's into the Viper bench and not over the glass into the stands. Mountainview is close to going down 5-on-3 there. Here's Linnell, a one-timer. Good save by Dallas Viega. He's going to hold on to that. Wilson on the draw here with Visser. And the draw won by the Vipers. Linnell couldn't get all of that shot. Barreling through the lane and comes harmlessly to De La Ciega. He'll hold on. So Mountain View has got 22:45 left in regulation of this game. And a Mount Everest to climb down 5-0 in game 7. Here's Rothenbusch up the far side to his brother Peyton Rothenbusch. He'll use the glass and get this one the full 200. Keegan Kingwell moves that up the far side for Brett Hoppus. Hoppus will come right in. Hoppus knocked off it. Centered. One timer from a ways out and a good glove save. Thomas De La Ciega right there. 2:18 to go in the second period. 1:17 remaining on the Red Deer Viper power play. Face off left side of De La Ciega. And this one is put in deep. There's Dowd. Lost it. Hoppus back to the line. Lapointe through traffic. Sails high and wide. Linnell knocked off the puck by Dowd. Dowd looking to get this one the length of the ice and will. Down to 50 seconds of power play time remaining for Red Deer. Here's Keegan Kingwell. Kingwell starts out, moves to Aiden Wilson. Wilson steps around the defender and he's knocked off the puck. It comes outside the line. Linnell is a step offside. A minute 39 to go here in the first period. 39 seconds of power play time remaining for the Vipers. You know, it's a long way to go, but I think it's fair to call this one an absolute must-kill for Mountain View. Done a good job so far. Here's Kalinowski back to the line. Dalton Engeltwit tries to work that down low to Lawson. And now Engeltwit lost it. And back here comes Mitch Visser. Visser looking to get right in. He shoots it. Save. Rebound. Engeltwit's got it. Final seconds coming off of the Red Deer power play. Is Engeltwit looking to center? Engeltwit. He still got it. Up top, Kalinowski. There's difference. He shoots. Good stop by De La Ciega. 40 seconds to go in the second period. Back to 5-on-5. Visser comes in again. Visser. Spin move. Anderson right off the bench. His shot blocked. There's Mac Difference. Difference tied up. It's going to work its way in deep. There's Visser. Visser tied up into the corner. Final seconds coming off the clock. Visser a chance to get a shot away, and he cannot do it. So the third period is coming up, and the Mountain View Colts have yet to find the score sheet. Red Deer's found it 5 times. 5-0, the Vipers lead it. So Mountain View needs a big period here, there's no question. But definitely you've seen crazier things happen in the jungle. But for now, 5-0, the Vipers lead. Going to the third period here in game 7. Second period shots, 12-9 for Red Deer. Makes a little bit of sense. They certainly had the better share of the power plays there in the second. Evan Ingram on the draw gets Lawson. And we are underway here in the third. Gotta think an early one would be the tonic here for the Mountain View Colts. Up the far side, it'll work for Bailey Lawson. Now back to Lapointe in the middle. Lapointe trying to get around his man, could not do so. This will come over to the near side for Colton Anderson. Anderson gets pasted. Engeltwit skates onto it. Now there's Brody Kalinowski over to the far side. Logan Linnell. Linnell trying to get right in. He cannot do it. Cole Sutherland. Sutherland taking off that. Now it's going to go over to Logan Linnell. Linnell trying to carry right in. Linnell to the near side. Lawson shoots. Good stop by De La Ciega. He covers it up. Minute 44 into the third. Still 5-0 for the Red Deer Vipers. Would be their third finals appearance inside of the last 5 years. Here's Hoppus. Shoots. Glove save. De La Ciega. Hoppus right on the doorstep. De La Ciega denies him. Just over 2 minutes in. Real good look there for Hoppus to extend the Viper lead to 6. One last game by 6. 8-2 was the final. Jacob Vanderzag puts this up to Visser. Now Josh Getty will come out the other side. Getty taken off that. Aiden Wilson's got it. Wilson, now Brown. Brown coming right in. Logan Brown, a one-timer. Brody Kalinowski takes that one away for the Red Deer Vipers. Kalinowski to the near side. Wilson couldn't get a shot away. One-timer Kalinowski denied. Now it's going to come to Wilson. Wilson trying to get this to Brett Hoppus. Vanderzank takes it away. Mitch Visser up the far side. Now Zane Leatherdale. Leatherdale, Josh Getty. Getty right in. Shoot save. Rebound. Oh, what a stop by Sears. Sears keeps it out point blank on the rebound. Josh Getty, the original shot. Visser right on the doorstep. Sears kicks it out. Stays at 5-goal Mountain View deficit. Draw one by the Red Deer Vipers. Here's Damian Chopek. Chopek moves to Declan Johnston. Johnston now to Lane Sim. Sim couldn't skate that one out. Johnston able to put it in deep, and Jack Vergallen skates right after it. Vergallen moves to Ryan Klink. Klink now up to Alan Klink, his brother. He'll skate it through center. Klink's got maybe a 2-on-1. Peyton Rothenbusch shoots it just wide. Sears keeps that in behind the goal for his defender, Keegan Kingwell, moving to Chopek in front of his own net. Chopek, Provost native, able to get it to Sim with a stump of a stick lift of his own. Sim skates right in, but he is deemed offside. 14 and a half to go here in the third period. Mountain View, if you're going to get back into this, they're going to get back in. You know, they probably, you got to get one at least in the next couple of minutes. Get yourself to within three or four at least within the final five to give yourself a real look at this thing. Here's Jelinas knocked off of it. Zarubiak right back the other way. Zarubiak carries it on the right. He's knocked off of it. It'll come to Austin Peterson. Peterson now to Regan Kime. Kime trying to get around his man. He cannot. Here's Austin Thorne. Thorne moves this one to Sullivan. Sullivan now trying to get a pass away. Cannot do so. He hits Thorne, though, as he gets it back. Thorne looking for Joslin out front. He shoots it himself. Glove save. Thomas Delasiega. 12:55 to go, third period. The Mountain View Colts, pending a comeback of epic proportions, look on pace to cough up a 3-1 series lead here in the North Division Final. Although it's virtual, a very, very small, minuscule measure of revenge for 2020. Perhaps. Don't speak too soon. Here come the Colts. Centering pass, Ingram. Ingram now Anderson shooting. Oh, it got blocked and changed direction, but Sears able to stay right with it and keep it out. Top line has been creating all kinds of chances tonight for Mountain View. However, nothing doing yet. Draw one back to the line, Rothenbusch. Ingram, one-timer. Anderson scores! Colton Anderson gets the Colts on the board. And this one is not quite over. Still half a period, over half a period to go. And a 4-goal deficit now as the Vipers cough this one up. Anderson just cranks this one-timer by Cole Sears. Scores 5-1. As Colton Anderson goes upstairs, he was denied on a couple of those earlier in the game and kept feeding him at that spot, and he's not going to miss every time, that's for sure. He doesn't there. 11:38 to go, so certainly some time left, especially if the Colts can get a quick one again. Here comes Lane Rothenbusch. Rothenbusch knocked off of the puck, and he's got it again. Raquel Lapointe will steal it for the Red Deer Vipers and skate it out himself here on the left wing. It's knocked off of him, though. Nearly taken right back into the Viper zone, but the Red Deer Vipers are able to recover. And now up the far side, there's Cole Sutherland. And a good back pressure there by Linnell, who denies that. So when put in deep by the Vipers, they'll make some changes. Jacob Vanderzag in behind the net, now with 9:40 to go here in this third period. Getty tries to get around Sutherland. Alligator right out front of one-timer stop by Sears. Unbelievable save. They had a 2-1-0 from about the hash marks in, but Sears able to keep it out. Now one-timer back the other way. Difference denied by Delisiega. Goaltender's trading stops now. Still quite the chasm in this game. It's Red Deer 5, Mountain View 1. But the Colts have ramped it up a bit. And now here comes Mac Difference. He's got a man on that. He hits off his right in. Wilson shoots it. Couldn't get all of it. Didn't quite get to the net. Here comes Lane Rothenbusch. Rothenbusch now to Alan Klink. Klink carries it in. Klink looking to center from behind the goal. Can't. Wilson nearly turns it over, but Hopp is able to move it up to Brody Kalinowski. Kalinowski one on two. Take it off the puck, trying to make a move around the defenseman, and Klink will try to carry it on Sullivan. Klink centering pass, Kalinowski. Good job there, takes it away, and Sears will say, I'll take this one, thank you very much. We'll get some fresh legs out here. And just a tick under seven to play. It's 5-1 for Red Deer still. Colts on the board and pressing. Really feel the season hang in the balance. This here's Klink back to Rothenbusch. Peyton Rothenbusch shoots and hit a body in front just wide. Klink knocked out of the puck by Chopek. Chopek tied up near corner. Sim in there as well. Sim knocks his man off, gets it to Spencer Yates. Yates trying to look for an outlet. Spins away from a check, gets it up to Lane Sim here on the left wing. Sim will carry it in. Sim tries to get around his man, cannot do so, and Jack Regallen takes away. Regallen knocked off of that one. Klink centering pass to Tristan Zarubi. Zarubiak there, he's intercepting that. Gains the line and puts it in deep for Red Deer. 5 1/4 to go, third period. 5-1, Red Deer leads. Peyton Rothenbusch up the far side. He's knocked off of the puck. Here's Peterson, tied up by Keegan Kingwell. Kingwell knocked off it, comes right to Sears. And Sears will hold on. 4:36 to go, third period. Still a 5-1 Viper advantage. Face off right side of Sears. Peterson on it. And the draw won by Red Deer. Here's Tristan Zarubiak. Zarubiak trying to drive it wide, unable to do so. Zarubiak moves over to the near side. Keegan Kingwell. Kingwell tries to send that one over to the far side for Difference. He does. Zarubiak shoots it. Excuse me, not Difference. He rings it off the mask of Delisiega. Good off from distance. And now chance back the other way. Taken away by a Mountain View penalty. And that Wyatt Jelinas minor might just be the nail in this coffin. And the nail was probably driven a little while ago. .337 to play here, third period, draw won by the Vipers. Here's Mac Difference over to Lawson. Lawson shoots it off of the post. Now Kalinowski, Lawson shot it wide. Rothenbusch will get the clear. 3 1/4 to play, third period, and Red Deer counting down the minutes to their third berth in 5 years in the Heritage Junior Hockey League Championship Series, where they will take on the Okotoks Bisons. One-timer shot off the post by Difference. Last time those two teams linked up in the finals, 2013, a series, it was a best of five, but a series nonetheless that Okotoks found a way to sweep. Lawson shoots it, blocker saved by Delisiega. Difference right out of the corner, shooting it, tight stop, Delisiega again. That was Okotoks' fourth consecutive championship. The Vipers would go on to provincials in that year and capture a bronze medal. I believe they did. Actually, I think they lost the bronze medal game from what I can remember. But nonetheless, so a rematch of 2013. It's been a while. Here's Hoppus off the draw. He puts it off the bar and in. It's 6-1 for Red Deer. Second power play goal of the night for the Vipers. And this one comes to a close. Unofficially, of course, but the Vipers will erase a 3-1 deficit in the North Division final. And on the backs of 5-2, 8-2, and what looks at the moment like a 6-1 victory in the final 3 games of the series, will go to the league final. Draw won by the Mountain View Colts. So the league final, we'll get underway with that on Friday. Right in front of shot save. Rebound, it's in. Sears knocked it into his own net. So Mitch Visser celebrates a goal in garbage time. And likely the final goal, this Didsbury faithful crowd will see in the HGHL 21 season. But their Colts will score. This one hits a weird angle off of this stick of Sears and goes up in behind him, and he just couldn't knock that away. Desperately tried to flail, and of course ends up knocking it into his own net. That's a tough one for Sears, but one that at the end of the day isn't going to matter a whole heck of a lot. Just under two to play. As Leatherdale puts it in deep. I mean, I'd want to say you get a quick one, pull the goalie, but still it's three. It's a tough road. Here's a chance. Lawson now shooting. It'll come to Delasiega. He will hold on. A minute one to go here in the third period. One to go. Draw one by the Colts, but the Vipers get it on the turnover. Vanderzag in deep. And we are in the final minute. Countdown to victory time for the Red Deer Vipers. Another North Division banner hung up in the service arena to go along with 17-18 and 16-17. This one will read 2020-21 North Division champions as the Red Deer Vipers, as I said, on the backs of a 5-2 win in Game 5, an 8-2 win in Game 6, and now a 6-2 win, at least that's what it looks like right now, here in Game 7, trailing 3-1 in the series. Will face off with the Okotoks Bisons for the league title. Final seconds come off, and the Red Deer Vipers, 2021 North Division champions. As the handshakes at center ice, another 7-game war in which the Vipers will prevail. Defeated the Three Hills Thrashers in 7 games in round 2. And now over the arch nemesis, Mountain View Colts, the two captains, Sutherland and Angletwit, link up for the handshakes at center ice, as do the rest of the boys, as they wish each other luck going forward. Dalton Angletwit skates forward to accept the trophy for the North Division. Not going to touch that, not a chance. He'll shake hands with Gary Bettman, who's here for some reason. That's fine. Gary Bettman, good guy. Good guy for showing up to Game 7 of the Heritage League Final in Didsbury. Love to see it. Love to see it. Growing the game. That's what we're doing here. Vipers win it. Viper victory here in Game 7. They are the North Division champions and will head to the Heritage Junior Hockey League Championship Series. Stay with us a little bit longer than normal. Usually we go away right after we show you the highlights. We're not going to do that today. We are going to take a look at the leading scores heading into the finals, stats, all that kind of stuff. Is the Mountain View Colts, who lead the North Final 3-1, fall in 7 games ultimately to Red Deer. And we'll get a look at your three stars as the Vipers move on to the league final. Bailey Lawson, he is your third star tonight. Goal and an assist for him. Second star, Brett Hoppus, a goal and an assist as well for Hoppy. This is his nickname. Hops. Beauty goal there on the power play upstairs. And the first star is Mac Difference. Pair of goals for him. En route to a 6-2 thrashing of the Mountain View Colts in the 7th game of the North Division Final. So the shots on goal end up 28-24. Red Deer. And of those 28 shots, 6 of them go in. Cole Sears, pretty good night for him. Let's go have a look. He turns aside 22-24 for a 9-17 and a 2 goals against average. So Cole Sears has come in. Granted, he wasn't as cold in this series, but in Game 7 of the Three Hill series, He came in ice cold. He hadn't played since the second last game of the regular season. Bilodeau played in both wins over Sylvan Lake in round one. Played all six games of the series up until game seven against Three Hills. Sears comes in, pitches the shutout, wins game seven, starts the first three games of the Mountain View series. The Vipers will go back to Bilodeau for game four. He loses. So Red Deer's down 3-1. Sears has come in for games 5, 6, 7. They won 5-2, 8-2, and 6-2. So pretty good performance by Cole Sears in these playoffs. If I do say so myself, we'll take a look at his full stats in just a bit. A tough night, conversely, for Thomas Delasiega. Terry facing 28 shots, allowing 6 for a 786 and a 6 goals against. That's a tough one for sure. However, not his fault. The Mountain View Colts just appeared tight all night here in the Game 7 in a series in which they trailed. And as I said, the smallest possible measure of revenge for sure as the Red Deer Vipers win Game 7 here tonight. Of course, the collapse in 2020 in the North Division semifinal, I recognize that was in real life, and this is a video game, but a tiny measure of revenge nonetheless, the literal smallest one that could exist. And as I say, this is all, it's all for fun, but still. Bailey Lawson gets us off and running early in this one as the Vipers capitalize on a turnover. Lawson puts this home, and the Vipers are up one early in this one. And then just over 4 minutes later, Lane Sim finds a loose puck in the slot. He scores for the second consecutive game. And the Vipers are up 2-0. Get a nice third line strike. Little give and go between Sim and Declan Johnston. Jackson Goodall, late in the first period, makes it 3-0 Red Deer. And Vipers, look, oh, they got a fourth line strike, and it's 3-0 Red Deer. Then 5 minutes or just under that into the second, Mac Difference on a delayed penalty call cashes for the Vipers. It is 4-0 Red Deer, and the Colts all the way on their heels. And then the next time would not be a delayed call, but would actually be a called penalty. An onside power play. Difference gets a second of the game. One timer on which Thomas Delasiega had no chance. So he lived through the first couple of goals. No chance on the Lawson goal. Give and go 2-on-1. Really no chance on the Sim goal. Turnover, Goodall, tap it in front. No chance on that goal. The first Difference goal. Second one for sure, no chance. No coverage over there on the far side. This one, good battle, one down low by Hoppus. I mean, he's there, but still, I mean, real tough. We'll go ahead and say no chance. But anyway, 5-0 Red Deer. Colton Anderson, midway through the third, gets the Colts on the board. One-timer upstairs by Colton Anderson, and it's 5-1. Mountain View, man, a little bit of life here with over half a period to play. You think maybe get a quick one? And, you know, you're right back in it. You're within three, still got a chance to pull a goalie. Maybe miracles happen. And they wouldn't on this night with 2:13 to go. Brett Hoppus on the power play. This maybe is the one Thomas Delasiega has a chance to stop. It's a pretty good shot, mind you. But you say maybe Delasiega, little quicker glove hand, makes the save on this. But, I mean, that's right off Crow's Nest and in. It's a good shot by Hoppus. He did that quite a bit, especially in the 2017 playoff run. So of the six goals he lets up, we'll say one is not on him, but he could maybe have stopped. The rest of them, just zero chance. Like I said, the Colts just tight all night. Didn't have the answer for a Red Deer club who had all the momentum, winning, as I said, two straight in the postseason, in games 5 and 6 by lofty margins. And then Mitch Visser gets kind of a fluky one. So it goes off the stick of Sears up and over top of him in the final 2 minutes. And Sears kind of realizes it a little bit late. And then when he does, he just tries to knock this into the corner by flailing around, trying to knock it in there with the stick. Trying to knock it away with the stick, but inadvertently, of course, doesn't time it right. Goes off the shoulder and into the net. And that is the final goal of the hockey game. But it comes about 4 days and $4 short. And that's the way this one goes. With 6-2 being the final for Red Deer, they will move on to the league final. They are the North Division champions. Let's get you, before usually we'd let you go here, but right now we are going to get you a look at stats and whatnot. So there you see the finals right here. Red Deer and Okotoks. Red Deer being the 3 seed in the, what they, the NHL's calling the West. We call it the North, because that's what we know it is. Red Deer, the 3 seed out of the North, will have home ice against the 5 seed out of the South. But Okotoks, look at that record, 8-0. As really they are 10-1, still impressive, as I had to do 2 different playoffs so we could do a 3-game series in round one. But you guys know that. But Okotoks hasn't lost in 9 playoff games, which is quite frankly ridiculous. But Red Deer will have home ice in the series, a best of 7. We're not going to do best of 5 like real life because there's no provincials. I don't have time to create every hockey team in Alberta, so we're just going to do the HJHL. So best of 7 in the finals. Let's take a look at your stats. First for individual stats, Declan Johnston leads the way. As you can see, all the Vipers have played 14 games. So it makes sense why you'd see a lot of Colts, a lot of Vipers, all Colts and Vipers, in fact. Noah Irvine is the closest one who's a non-Colt or Viper. He only played 11 games with the Cubs. Was 4-6, 10 in 11 games. Of course, the Vipers play 14, 2 7-game series, a 6 and a 7 for Mountainview, but they play 13. So it makes sense why they're all kind of in the upper echelon. But anyway, Declan Johnston, 7-10-17 through the first 14 games of the playoffs. Mac Difference lead the league in goals in the postseason with 10. I should make sure that's the case. But yeah, he is. So those are your individual statistics leaders. Let's have a look at Okotoks. You're not going to see a lot of Bisons because they've only played 8 games. Of course, I had to call them Calgary because Okotoks doesn't exist in the game. Ty Alger and Ty Witzke leading the way, both point-per-game players, 4-4-8 and 2-6-8, respectively, through the 8 games thus far. Of course, this doesn't include the first-round stats, unfortunately. There's no way to do that. As, like I said, that had to be 2 separate playoffs. Austin Obrey, Tyson Scott, Riker Franchak, Harrison, these are all kind of the culprits for the Bisons going into the league final. Let's have a look at goaltenders and prepare yourself, because you're about to see a big reason why Okotoks finds their way into the league final. Devin Regan, a 960 save percentage through 2 rounds of the playoffs at a 1-1-2. Cole Sears is Red Deer starter, rocking an 8-9-8 and 2-7-2. He had a tough night, giving up 8 goals in game 3 of the series. So that probably has a little bit to do with it. But nonetheless, he's 5-2. But Devin Regan, 2 goose eggs to his name as well. They're certainly going to be a thorn in the side of the Vipers in the league final, which, as I said, will get underway Friday. So there's some of your individual statistical leaders in goaltenders and skaters. Let's take a look at your team stats. So really all we have left to focus on now is Okotoks at 8-0, 22 goals for, 9 goals against. They're averaging 2.75 goals a game, and only a 1.13 against. Of course, Regan a big part of that. Red Deer scoring 4.14 a game, but of course letting up 3.29. And so you look at these, Okotoks, even at Red Deer's tough goals against per game, they're not quite scoring enough. So we'll see if the Bisons, they've won a couple of low scoring games. It should be interesting what happens in the league final. As you look at Medicine Hat, who's scoring 2.55. Right, so they're scoring less than Okotoks per game. And then they beat Coaldale in the first round. They only scored 1.75 a game. So it's the first time Okotoks going to have to go up against a team that scores quite a bit. And even look at Mountain View at 3.38. You know, that still is... So it'll be interesting. Should be a good final. That's what you got for goals for against. Look at the special teams coming in. The Mountain View Colts went 60%. The Alberta Thrashers, Three Hills Thrashers, 60% on the power play, because in that series, the Vipers, if the Vipers had a half decent penalty kill in that series, they would have won that series in five games. But the Viper penalty kill in the second round series against Three Hills was, get this, 35%. Not very good. So, kind of discount that one. But the Mountain View Colts get through the first two rounds of the playoffs with a 31% power play. Red Deer a little bit down there at 28. Okotoks at 30. So pretty similar power plays, both pretty good power plays for both Okotoks and Red Deer. You look at the PK. And even now, like, you look, Red Deer's only got to 50% on the PK. And so granted, that would mean, I think the penalty kill in the Mountain View series was all right to jump at 20 points. But still, it was abysmal in the Three Hills series. It's going to have to get better, especially against that really good Okotoks power play. And the Okotoks penalty kill lights out at 90. So if this series comes down to special teams, you know, it might favor the Bisons quite a bit. Let's look at Medicine Hat. Although Medicine Hat's penalty power play was only 21%, so quite a significant difference between playing Red Deer and playing Medicine Hat. And of course Goldale's, it was only 16. So we'll see what happens. Finals get underway Friday night, 7 o'clock. It should be a lot of fun. Anything else we should maybe go through here? I think we're good. Well, let's take a look at the playoff tree. That's what we look like through the first three rounds of the postseason. And we get underway. Finals Friday night from Red Deer, 7 o'clock. We'll see you then.